A common way to simulate the suspension of a car in a game is the raycast method. I would like to show you how I implemented this method in Godot. Maybe it is interesting for one or the other to see the complete process in detail from start to finish. The car in our simulation consists of four shock absorbers, the wheels and the body. First we create the shock absorber. This will be called wheel controller in our simulation. It consists of a simple Node 3D object to which a script is attached and a raycast 3D element. The script determines how deep the raycast has penetrated the ground and calculates the force that the spring should exert on the body. We save this scene. It will be needed four times later in the simulated car. The behavior of our car is essentially determined by a rigid body 3D. The mass of this object plays an important role when setting the parameters for the shock absorber. We call this pure physics model of a car vehicle controller. By the way, I found the formulas to calculate the parameters of the shock absorber in Wikipedia. A script is also attached to the vehicle controller. This applies the forces to the rigid body 3D that each of the four wheel controllers has calculated. I'm not quite sure if the way I calculated the weight is correct in line 15 in vehiclecontroller.gd. If not, please let me know in the comments. Our rigid body should have a certain size. Here we set it up. We also position the four shock absorbers. One shock absorber in our simulation is the wheel controller scene. Next, we create a scene that contains only the body of our car. By the way, Monterrey is the fantasy name of an imaginary car manufacturer. We do the same again, but this time for the wheel model. As with the body, we first load the GLTF file of the wheel model. We need two scenes of the wheel model, one for the left side and one for the right side. The vehicle controller stands for a general car without visual features. For our Monterrey, we will create a derivative of the vehicle controller and give it a body and wheels. Finally, we create the floor on which our car will stand. For this, we have already prepared a simple 3D model in GLTF format. From this object, we create a scene that will later be displayed in our main scene. We can then simply move our floor scene into the main scene and place it there. Now we can insert our finished car model into the main scene. We add a camera and the lighting. Then we can test our suspension. Finally, let's try out what happens when we gradually reduce the damping.